Hey guys, hope you are well. I took a break from this channel for a bit. Just to regroup, uncompress. I'm still playing around with some of the amps. Back down to those ones. The other one's over there. Keep switching them back and forth, including the other one there. Because I like the different sounds. And every time I do it, I pick out something different that I didn't hear before. This one here still works pretty good. It's a nice amp. Solid. Anyway, yeah, so we're going to be doing some more cable mods. I want to build some more cables. What else? I would like to start doing some more reviews on headphones. I quite enjoyed that. Haven't done them in a while. I'm not even sure if these ones even work anymore. They've been sitting on the rack so long uncharged. But, yeah, we're going to start doing headphones again. I totally enjoy that. One thing I do have to do, though, is I have to rebuild my Akai AA1050, 1030.
Yeah.
I noticed in a couple of my videos there was a hum in the right channel. And obviously, I can't put it off anymore. I'm going to have to totally recap the amp inside this and maybe do a bit of the power supply. One of my subscribers actually left me a schematic for it, and I actually uploaded it to a cloud for you guys to access. There's a link somewhere on my web page or my channel anyway, so if you want it, it's there. Actually, I've been trying the Yamaha, what is it, RX-V385 or 65? Anyway, I didn't give this enough credit. It actually does sound pretty good. Mind you, it does. I am using the outputs that I installed on it for this amp, these amps down here. It sounds good with the Class D. It sounds good with the internal amp, but I can easily drive that amp to distortion with these speakers. So, you know, I don't like an amp like that. I like an amp where you can crank it and it can handle the full load. This one cannot. It's actually disappointing. I find the old amp there sounds like it has more power than this one. But I think this one's basically designed for surround, so. It does lack inputs in the back. It only has two. So you can have a turntable and a CD player, and that's it. Get around that, you'll have to use a preamp. But other than that, it works. It's silent. It's smooth. I mean, once you get used to the controls on the remote, it's actually not that bad. But anyway, I digress. Give me a couple of weeks, and we'll come up with something new. That's one of the reasons why I stopped posting videos on soundtracks and that, because obviously there's an issue. I'm going to try it with this one and see what it sounds like. Because basically what I do is I'm using the Tascam, and I plug it directly into the headphone jack. And that's basically why I had the hum from that one there. So, but we'll try it out, see how it works. Anyway, be safe. Stay healthy. Later, guys.